Warning! In this episode of NCTV, my hay fever decided to be a bitch and block my nose. It hurt for me, and I'm sorry if you can't understand me. So, yeah, it sucks to know that I have hay fever and that I hate being sick. I know. Sad face. Hey guys, do you know what I really don't like? Being sick. Sometimes it's good. Like, you get out of school for a couple of days, and you get to sit in bed all day, watching cartoons and eating food that doesn't help at all. That's what I call a holiday. Anyone agree? Being sick also has its bad/bad-timed visits. Like, take me. I'm a singer, right? So I get tonsillitis a lot. The mild kind, don't worry. I don't have some creepy doctor chopping away at my throat with a sharp blade. I mean, the worst case scenario is just that he sneezes in the middle of surgery and then he chops my throat and then I drown on blood and I die and I don't even know. Wow, that's cheery. Ugh. Anyway, back to the vlog. It sucks to be sick, I know. But once it's over, you feel good, right? Sometimes. I mean, take the people that have type 1 diabetes. They don't know they're sick when they first get it. They go to the toilet a lot, they drink a lot, and they get really tired really quick. I should probably explain this a little bit easier so that you guys know what it means. Let's say this. It's glucose. And let's say this. It's insulin, right? You get glucose from the stuff you eat every day. And you get insulin from a vital organ called the pancreas in your body. So your body needs insulin to make glucose come together to give you energy, right? Well, when your pancreas gets damaged, when you get type 1 diabetes, the glucose starts to get... Well, when your pancreas stops making insulin, glucose gets really lonely. It can't come together to give you energy. That's why people who just get diabetes get really tired really quick. Okay, since there isn't enough insulin in your body, and you eat without even knowing that you need the insulin, the more glucose is made. But since insulin isn't making it into energy, what's glucose gonna do? But sit around and watch themselves multiply. So since it can't be made into energy, and all it can do is sit around and watch itself multiply, where's it gonna go when you get bored? Well, when they get bored. It goes to your piss. 10 points if you know where your piss goes. Yeah. That's why they pee a lot. And lastly, I may be wrong about this, but because the glucose is spilling into your pee, and when you pee, practically all the water in your body gets sucked out when you pee, so that's why you've got to drink a lot. So that your body can sustain the amount of water in your body. I may be wrong, sorry if I am, but I only just learned about this like 2 days ago. So, now that you know that you've got a type 1 diabetes, because you've been to the doctor and you've had to stay at the hospital for a few days, there's another type of vacation, but you're around a whole bunch of sick people. Hang on, but you're one of them. Anyway, so since your body can't make the right amount of insulin to help you make energy, you have to inject it into yourself with this.
Do you like it?
And you can check your blood sugar level, that's your glucose level, with this. Yep. If you want to learn about it more than what I've already told you, I found a website called diabetessymptomsonline.com. Down there. That's where the link is. I'm not getting paid by them, by the way. Nope. I just found it and thought it was cool. Now onto a serious note. If you're wondering why I made a vlog about type 1 diabetes, it's because recently a friend of mine told me that he was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes, and it kind of scared me because it was so sudden. So I thought I'd make a video telling you guys what it's about and not to be shocked. But he's okay. It's like, he acts like he doesn't actually have it. It's like showing that he's strong no matter what he has. He used to be on a basketball team, but because he got really tired and he had to drink a lot, he was kicked off the team. No, he's not allowed back on. Which is kind of sad. Also, famous musician Nicholas Jerry Jonas from the Jonas Brothers. The drummer slash lead guitarist also has type 1 diabetes, which is kind of sad. He got it in 2005 and came out about it in 2007. As you know, he gets up on stage and does some of the wildest things, or is that Kevin? He gets up on stage and does some of the wildest things he can, and he's still going strong, no matter what. Like my friend, it's like he acts like he doesn't actually have it. So Nicholas Jerry Jonas wrote a song called A Little Bit Longer, which should be playing right now, I hope. No, sadly, there isn't a cure for type 1 diabetes, or type 2. Yes, there are lots of types of diabetes. But I'm glad that he's alive, Nick and my friend. So if you, a friend or a family member, or like someone that's kind of close to you, but you just know gets type 1 diabetes and they tell you, don't be shocked. Well, you can be shocked, because I was. And because, like, oh my gosh, I don't know how to explain it. Just be supportive. Don't think of them as, like, a reject or a person that's just lower. Think of them as one of us. Just they're different in a inner body way. Although we all are. So I hope you guys liked my little lesson about type 1 diabetes. If you want to see more, leave a comment telling me if you want to see more. I'm gonna go, guys. Peace out, Girl Scout. Oh, comment question of the day. Do you have type 1 diabetes, or do you know someone who has type 1 diabetes? Tell me their story, like how they found out or something like that. I don't know. I'm gonna go. Okay, guys. Bye, guys.
All the highs and lows are gone. A little bit longer and I'll be fine. I'll be fine.